Previously in Breaking Point.
Aidan, please tell us, how does it feel to be on the verge of getting behind the wheel for your very first race?
I feel like a little kid. I look around and I'm surrounded by my heroes.
And tell me about Casper Ackermann. How is that relationship coming along?
It wasn't my fault.
Well, whose fault was it then?
He tried to stop them from signing you. Didn't want to play babysitter. We all feel sorry for you, mate. You never stood a chance with him.
I had a call this week from Christian Horner. You're being watched.
You know what his problem is, don't you? Thinks you're getting too old.
You want respect, you give respect! That's how it works!
How about you give me a little respect?
How about you earn it first?
I'm done.
You what?
I'm retiring.
Why didn't it work out between you two?
He's on more money than me.
What? He didn't want me on the team.
Didn't I? And you thought I was past my best.
So none of this is true?
There's always gossip in the paddock. And ever since he's arrived, there's been one man at the centre of it all. I want us to push for fourth. I want us to beat Butler. And I want that seat to go to you.
So Alfa Romeo potentially on track to really upset AlphaTauri here. Butler's closing in on Ackermann. Down the inside he goes! And they hit each other! Butler into the barrier, and that looks to be the end of the race for him. The Dutchman looks to be continuing at.
It's great to see him still in this fight, Crofty.
Good return, Aiden. What about Casper?
We let Aiden pass.
Let Aiden pass.
We did it.
We did it. Have you seen the crash?
Butler's okay?
Bruised ego, perhaps.
What was it like bringing a brand new team to the F1 grid?
You know, the first time you see a car, your car, with your branding, your name on it, in an official race, alongside Ferrari, McLaren, Mercedes, that's what it's all about.
You make it sound like a dream come true.
If only.
When did you first get a sense of what was in store for Connor Sport?
2022 season, straight out of the box. The drivers were always going to clash. That was a calculated risk. But the car. The car had problems.
We're midway through the Miami Grand Prix. It's been a cracking race so far, and it's all up for grabs.
Absolutely, Crofty. Some fantastic driving here today. Especially, I have to say, from Aidan Jackson. I don't think I've ever seen a Connor Sport car being put through its paces quite like this.
This is a team, Connor Sport, that have got a lot to prove this season, but Jackson might just be the man to do it.
Okay, Aidan, nice job so far. Let's try and bring that gap down to the car ahead if you can.
Copy that.
Ahead is 1.8 seconds. Okay, you're in the top 10. Our teammate by 9.0 seconds. The car ahead's coming to fit the mediums. The car ahead now running medium tyres. Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by, 1.7 seconds. That's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left.
I'm losing power! Why am I losing power?
Copy that. We see it. We're looking into it. Okay, I'm afraid you're going to have to retire the car, please, Aidan. Retire the car.
You're joking!
I'm sorry, Aidan. Pull over now, please. Pull over now.
This is getting ridiculous!
And that's agonising for Jackson. Just a few laps left to go, and he's out of the Miami Grand Prix!
Oh, well, every race, the car looks like a constant problem for Konnersport. It must be devastating for the drivers.
Confirmation, as the car comes to a halt, the Konnersport's Aidan Jackson won't be seeing the checkered flag today. But it looks like his teammate will. Jackson's DNF put Devon Butler in a position where he might just be able to secure some points for Konnersport.
Aiden's out.
Yep, engine problem, I'm afraid.
Good job you got me.
All right, Devon, don't push it too hard. We cannot risk losing both cars here.
It's in the bag, mate.
All okay, Aiden?
Yeah, how's Devon doing?
Yeah, he's doing all right, mate. He looks like he's going to bring home some points for the team.
Good for him.
If it's not one thing, then it's another. Did you not see what happened out there today?
Aiden, I agree with you 100%. We are doing everything we can. I know the car is not perfect, but...
Andreo, it's every race. Do you know how I look losing easy points like this?
Knock, knock. Sounds like there's a right show going on in here. What am I missing?
Not now, Devon.
Aiden and I were just discussing issues with the car.
Again? I thought that was all in hand. I had no problems today. Smooth. You know what they say, a shoddy workman always blames his tools. mate, you can look at my setup data anytime you want. I've told you that, it might help.
And I've told you before, it's not a setup issue. The problem is...
Jackson, that was the problem with the 2022 season. Ask anyone. I mean, at the end of 21, everyone thought Aiden was going to be signed by one of the big three. But I guess they couldn't reach an agreement, so we both signed for Konnersport.
And do you think that affected Aiden?
That's no secret. Now, for that 22 season, Jackson was a nightmare.
Aiden, hey, I wanted to give you a heads up. Now look, the crew has shared the latest telemetry data with us.
Fine, but I don't think it'll tell me anything I don't already know.
Just humor me, okay? I'd like you to go through it. Let me know if anything jumps out. I'm keen to iron out these problems as quickly as possible for you.
Sure thing. Thanks, Andrea.
No thanks needed. I've got your back, Aiden. Remember what I said when you joined the team. I won't let you down. Ackerman won't let me hear the end of it.
Yeah, sounds like Casper. You know he told me the same, right? It's just tricky, what with the car and Devon poking his nose in any chance he gets.
There is a lot going on for sure, but we're a team. We'll get there. I'll have a word with the Devon. Tell him to give you some space, both on and off the track, okay?
Yeah, all right. Good luck with that.
Hey, boss, got a couple of minutes?
Andreo! Just going over those last-minute strategy changes you sent over.
Okay.
Yeah, I just want to make it clear, whatever happens out there today, I get pit priority, yeah?
Well, we'll see how the race develops. See? If you need priority, you'll get it. But I can't go into the race with that on the table.
Look, we all know Jackson's not pulling his weight. Now, if you want the points, I need to make sure he's not going to get in my way. Do you get me?
Devon, we've talked about this. Give Aiden some space. It's not about you getting in the way of each other. It's about everyone pulling together, racing as a team.
Of course, yeah. So, pit priority, yeah? All right, ciao.
turn two we go now. Butler comes out of the pit lane. Jackson is right there with him. This is dicey, Ant. Neither one of these two wants to give way.
This would have been a lot cleaner if Jackson had just let him go. He's just not giving him an inch.
They continue onwards, still wheel to wheel, almost touching there as well, as we head down the straight towards the next chicane. Nothing to separate either car, and through the chicane we go. And now Jackson sends them both off the track and Butler over a curb. That looked nasty.
I do believe that one of their cars is damaged here, Crofty. I think it's Butler.
Damage, Ant, but also they've lost places too.
Unbelievable and totally unnecessary as well.
Well, one damaged car, places now to make up. What a complete mess that was.
Down. We'll look at it in the debrief later, but right now I want you to go and get those places back. Come on, let's go. Remaining. time now. Keep it up. Gap to your teammate behind is 15.7 seconds. Okay, the gap behind is 1.8 seconds. Okay, that puts you in fifth, P5. Gap ahead, please. 6.0 seconds.
there, banging wheels, not giving each other room on track. It was entertaining, of course, but definitely boring on wheels.
Yeah, we enjoyed it, certainly. And Adrian Jackson, well, he'd have enjoyed the result. He did well to recover.
He did do well to recover, but, you know, you never want to see two cars, if you're the team boss, seeing two cars hit each other. It's rule number one, don't hit your teammate.
Given all the problems they've had this season, though, getting one car over the finish line, that's probably a big result for them today. Welcome, then, to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.